Good evening. This morning we woke up to the front pages with ads promoting not a big car or house or any other FMCG product, but a book. A book by popular but also quite a controversial author, Chetan Bhagat. It soon became the most talked about thing online. Is this any way to market a book? Many were outraged, but could it also be a brilliant marketing plan? Let's take a look at how else Chetan Bhagat is selling the book. So that's the trailer actually, which has been released by Flipkart and Chetan Bhagat. And to talk about this, whether it is a huge marketing gimmick or really the future of books, we have Chetan Bhagat joining us from Mumbai. And also in studio, we have two other authors who are critically acclaimed. We have Ira Pande and we have Samit Basu. Thank you all for joining us over here. So our first talking point is the front page ad, the jingle. Is this the future of book retail? Chetan Bhagat, you obviously think so.
Well, I was very lucky. We had a tie-up with Flipkart and, Flipkart came. It was actually Flipkart's idea to do a big bang. And I never thought how it will work. Like you said, it's never ever been done for a book before. But, I really believed in this book and they said, let's do it. And it's a very unusual title. And we'll go for it. And I thought it's good because, I today don't think I'm competing with other writers. I think I'm competing with apps, I'm competing with video games, with movies, with TV. So to break that clutter and make a book rise, you have to create something compelling so that all the youngsters start talking about books again.
Start talking about books. But what did you make of the fact that most of the people, it was a top trend, but most of them were cracking jokes at Half Girlfriend. That's the name of your upcoming book.
It's an incorrect assessment that most was correcting jokes. That's the world, the elitist world, the elite snobbery world, which probably is a small circle that exists on Twitter. But there has literally been a phenomenal response all over the social media on the book. There's a phenomenal response at Flipkart itself, where the pre-orders are being accepted. There is a section, who probably feel the book is too simple, or they probably want to emphasize that they have really refined tastes and everything. But they are kind of missing the point. I think they should have understood what I am all about. I am about reaching people. Mm-hmm. I want to make every kid in this country read a book. There are many millions whose English may not be as good as the people on Twitter you're talking about. It's a second language for them. They don't think in English. They find it hard. And should those people never read English books? Or should there be no English books written for them? And okay. That's the question they need to answer. But my mission is to make every kid in India read an English book. Every kid in a slum in India will read an English book one day. And I'm committed to that goal. So if they want to mock that, it's up to them. It reflects more on them than me.
We don't want to be called elitist. Actually, I read the first chapter that you posted. I really liked it as well. That's a story that will, it made me want to read on. And we have lots of young people as well. Some of them are your fans, some not so much. But I want to ask the experts over here, Ira Pande and Samit Basu. Samit Basu, first of all, you're one of those people who was making fun of it on Twitter. Why
Absolutely.
So?
Absolutely. No, see, I've been publicly and privately supportive of the phenomenon that Chetan has been down the years. But then as I watched him masterfully lead the entire media by the nose for more than a decade now, I realized that, when this cover comes out on the front page of TOI, I can either send a message to Chetan saying, congratulations again, you've done it again. But he will be responding to Katrina Kaif and Sajid Nadiadwala. So obviously he might not have the time to respond to me. Or I could make a little fun of it and I could get to come on TV and talk about it.
So mission accomplished for you.
Absolutely. It's a fully
It's also good publicity for your book.
Absolutely. And see, no one is going to call me on TV to talk about my work.
Listen,
right? So I've been writing for 10 years. I can win awards in the West. I can, do all kinds of fancy things. But I'll come on TV when it's Chetan Bhagat being made fun of Twitter. So, we understand how these things work as well, and Chetan has in fact taught a lot of writers how to do this, and it's amazing actually. And if you look at what Chetan has achieved in the course of the last 10 years, Like, he's now moved beyond, as he was saying, he's moved beyond books into the kind of app ether, you know.
Competing with video.
And he's still playing this victim card. And whereas every writer in the country is desperately jealous of the success he's achieved. Right. Yeah. So all these so-called elite small circle people are sitting in their small circles crying about how they can't be Chetan Bhagat. And I find it both amazing and amusing that he seems at all sad instead of just mocking them.
Okay.
Right back.
I'll get Chetan Bhagat to actually respond to playing the victim card, as you call it. But Ira Pande, as someone, I mean, you're a writer and you're an acclaimed writer and you've also been in publishing. So what do you make of this way people seem... Is it the old fashioned in us, is the people who lack vision and saying that, you know, we've never seen ads, such huge ads, promos for books. Is that also hopeful in a way?
Look, Sunetra, we come, or at least I come from a generation when a book was considered a book, a valuable addition to one's mind space. Now a book has become a product, it's become a marketing product. So whether you're selling chocolate or a car or a boot polish or a book, you apply a certain management perspective to the whole thing. To that extent, I think Chetan really deserves everyone's, as Samit says, he has really shaken up the publishing world, because I just met somebody who worked, in fact, as an editor, commissioning editor for Penguin, and she was saying how she had, when the first manuscript came to her, she thought that it was absurd because he'd sent the entire package of the marketing plan he had for it. And she found it absurd. And this is exactly where he's caught them out. You know, all the big publishing houses who had these la-di-da editors who came from New York and London and all these fancy places had a very fixed idea of the kind of literature they wanted to promote, as though this was a land of noble savages who had to be taught how to read. Oh. You know, there was that kind of a thing. What he has done is made it possible not just for everyone to read a novel, but for everyone to aspire to write a novel. Now, that is something, as a trend, I'm sure Samit will be, as a futuristic writer, be able to tell you more about it. But that's what I worry about. So there are two aspects to Chetan's persona in my mind.
That's positive.
One very positive, that he's taught the marketing and the publishing people not to apply stupid formulas to every author, saying this will work, this will not work, you know, this doesn't sell in England, this doesn't sell in South India. Who are you to decide? Let the reader decide what he or she wants. But so that he's broken that mold. For that I admire him, and he's pushed it through.
But what's the not?
The not so nice thing is that, you know, we have to make, I'm afraid, a distinction between... how should I call it? Aesop goal for the mind. You know, something that holds your
laxative
head
for the
rather
mind.
Than just read a book and toss it over.
Okay.
That mustn't happen. I mean, there's a great market and a great value in popular pulp fiction, but don't ever confuse it with serious writing.
Chetan Bhagat, I want you to try and respond to both of them. Samit Basu, at what he's saying, that you're playing the victim card again.
You know, there is, I don't know, you know, maybe I have a limited IQ, but I don't know whether they are praising me or criticizing me. I don't know. Listen,
but
I mean, I'm not doing any
Ira Pande suddenly praised.
Samit said, there is no victim card at all possible for me, because I better not be playing victim card. I am having it quite easy compared to other writers. I understand the pressures. I know how frustrating it is to write well and not have the world notice you. I know that. And actually, if they have the right to do it. However, to bash a book, the book is not even out yet. And if Twitter is having a blast at it, then what do you make of it, right? I mean, is there any basis? Have you even read the book? So, and the second thing, Ms. Pandey is right, but she's wrong in her diagnosis that the book can be sold like a product. And this is where they get it wrong. They think, I've gone to IM, so, you know, I've done some, I say, okay, it's a product, so it'll sell like a product. There are so many ads that come. Not every ad gets talked about.
But you know, Chetan, I must...
Every day ads
Chetan
are coming
Bhagat,
on people. Have you ever talked about an ad?
If I can just...
Let me just finish. The key difference, let me just explain to everyone once and for all this product thing that comes. Because I am very good at marketing, there is no doubt. But a soap or a toothpaste is something you need. You need on a daily basis. A book is not something you need. If the book doesn't work for you, if it's not relevant to you, you will not pick it up. You, even if I sell it as a product, you will not pick it up. You have to feel the need to read it. You feel that I will read it, I'll enjoy it, I'll like it. And it is not as frivolous if I've been around for 10 years. You ask anybody what is the story of two states, they will tell you 3 years later what is the story of two states.
Yes.
So they are not read and toss and the kind of derogatory elitism that creeps in every now and then, you know, laxative and things like that. I mean, what is this? What is this? I mean, are you saying that millions of people who read in English in India, my books are in English, I'm not even talking of a Hindi movie here, they're all foolish. They're all foolish people.
Now, what's interesting is
that they don't know what they're doing.
In fact, we have these young people over here, and they were having, just before the show, they were having a little bit of an argument over here, these three of them over there, because you're a fan. And what do you make of this kind of debate happening over here? Because the two ladies here didn't agree with you.
I think the people who are liking their work, and they have all the points, he is not thinking about out of the box. And tomorrow they will say he's writing about the script
You've
for the script.
You read all his books?
Yeah.
And
definitely.
Do you read other people as well, or just Chetan Bhagat?
I like just Chetan Bhagat. I don't Chetan find Bhagat, some other author interesting.
Sure. So, and when people, what did you have to say? How were you disagreeing with them?
My point was this, that he started his career as a writer. He's supposed to write for his readers, basically. But ma'am said, now this thing is turning to more of marketing. So this marketing factor has somehow affected his skills.
Can
I feel that.
Yeah, go ahead, Samit.
Sunetra, see, this is where I fundamentally disagree with both what Ira said and what the young reader there is saying. Which is that it's stupid to think of Chetan as just a marketing phenomenon, because you could dismiss him as that maybe after one or two books, but he's been far too successful for far too long for us to deny
and
that
there's
an essential connection that he makes with a lot of readers for which he deserves nothing but praise and admiration.
Yeah.
Right. So if we fall into the trap of, you know, this whole classification of books, and I can say this with great passion, because when I met Chetan first, this was 10 years ago, we were both starting out, and we were both facing the same kind of, you know, small circle. So I'm writing in a genre that is not considered high lit and so on.
Why haven't you read a Chetan Bhagat book?
No,
Ira Pande hasn't read one as well.
My tastes are completely eccentric, and I'm reading books that no one else in India is reading, and I'm not going to read or see something just because it's popular among a large bunch of people. I've started I've bought and started a number of Chetan's books. It's not the kind of book I read, so I'm not going to read it. And it's my choice as a, you know, reader to not read it. He's not read mine.
Chetan, you haven't read Samit Basu's book?
But he's come to a launch.
I have read Turbulence. Hello, I've read Turbulence. What are you saying?
Is there a kind of, is Chetan Bhagat right, Ira Pande, in saying
you have
that
not come for my launch, I have come. Listen, let me tell you guys something. My marketing budget, guys. My marketing budget, I'll tell you my marketing budget today. Zero. I have never spent on marketing.
But front page ads cost a lot of money,
I didn't pay for
Chetan
this ad, Flipkart did. Behind also. I am just telling you, if there was Flipkart didn't, I wouldn't have done it. I'm just saying, this is the first time it has come, and that too with a partner. I have never spent.
Just to put it into perspective for our viewers, a front page ad in Times of India might be costing anywhere around 10 lakhs, and any new author would be getting, Ira Pande, how much did you say you got for your first book?
For my first book, 30,000.
30,000.
Listen, most people are paying to get their books out. I just want to add one thing, which is that this is one thing that we've had this Chetan Bhagat or not Chetan Bhagat debate for 10 years.
Yeah, we're just talking about the marketing.
Yeah. There's one thing that I don't know if anyone's brought it up, which is that Chetan Bhagat has one quality that other writers don't have, which is he has star quality. He's basically the Salman Khan of Indian literature. And his and since he wrote Salman's last film,
I'm taking off my shirt now.
We've all seen Salman take off his shirt.
I'm doing it, for you, I'll do it.
See, now, here's the thing. Now, most writers live in this angsty Western story of their own life, which is like a dark, depressing novel.
Yeah.
Chetan's life has been like a Salman Khan movie, where the hero just wins and wins and wins and wins and wins.
Yeah,
and of course, this is going to get a kickback from everyone.
Okay. And before we break,
I feel bad that, you know, maybe the way I expressed it came out as a kind of carping, nasty, you know, evil fairy who's been denied whatever. That's not it. I genuinely belong to a different generation and a different kind of readership.
Yeah.
It's difficult for me now to change tracks and suddenly to start reading comics or, you know, things which younger people are reading, or even the Chetan Bhagat. But Let me just say that there is one quality in Chetan Bhagat which I admire, because he has what the Bombay film industry used to have, is the ability to pick up a social trend and a problem before it became visible to the political
world. For example, give us a quick one and then we take a break.
This whole thing about inter-caste marriages, you know,
and
the
English
caste divides.
Which is so topical right now?
English, you know, the great thing about English not being the language of a vast number of people. Look at the enormous debate that the rise of the BJP and of the middle class India
but
and small towns is something that he has been, you know, the small town aspirational youth, which has been his constituency, by the way, and which he's extremely proud of. Is an invention, I won't say it was an invention, but it was discovery of Chetan Bhagat, and now look how every political party is chasing that. He is actually also, apart from being a brilliant marketing chap, he admits it himself, also a very sharp political mind.
Okay, and Irabani, we need to take a short break now. When we come back, how it affects other writers, the whole industry, and all of us as readers who love to read as well. We'll be back in just a bit.